In all the videos that I've made now on arthritis and arthritis treatment at home, and the hundreds or let's say thousands of comments, have been a number of questions, and some questions seem to come up quite a lot. I answer the questions in the comments as much as I can. It's very difficult to get to all of them, but they are questions that seem to come up over and over again. So I thought it would be a good idea to make a short video with my top four questions, or your top four questions, I suppose that is, and address them here. So welcome to ShapeFixer. My name is Andrew. I am a nutritionist, but I'm also an osteoarthritis sufferer, and I had really bad hip arthritis. I was slated for a hip replacement, did not have surgery, and was able through diet and exercise and self-management at home to resolve the issue in my cartilage and in my hip to the point that I can now run 10 miles over the mountains. So this can be done. It's not a guarantee, and I've done videos explaining why there are some cases it can't be resolved, and so then surgery would be important. But in a lot of cases, and I would say the vast majority of cases, you can resolve it. So where are we here? The first question that seems to come up quite a lot from people, and these are people who have seen my videos, and they come back and they say, right, I have adopted your protocol. I'm trying to do what you did through diet, through rehabilitation exercises, through appropriate rest with the right supplements and controlling the inflammation. How long does this take? And that is a great question, because of course that's what everybody wants to know. I don't know. And the reason I say I don't know is because I don't know you. So there are so many factors that will go into how long it takes you to recover. For example, how old are you? Do you smoke? If you smoke, your healing process is going to be worse. If the older you are, the slower it tends to be, because it's metabolic processes in play. How severe was your damage? The more severely damaged your joint, the longer it's going to take, logically, for it to recover. How stressed are you? If you have a very stressful lifestyle, or you're suffering from a lack of sleep, your cortisol level will be high, that's your stress hormone, and that interferes with the healing process. How good is your diet actually? You might think you're following the right diet, but you may have missed something, and you may not be getting all the nutrients you need to help your joint to grow, or you might still be eating something that's interfering with it. What other medications are you on? If you are on other medications, those medications might impact the regenerating process. So I think the answer is to be patient. And if you see progress, then you know it's working. Okay? It's not like you're sick and 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 boom, one morning you're perfect. It doesn't work like that. So you will be able to tell over a 3-month period whether or not you are getting any better. And if you are getting better, then you carry on, because you keep getting better. If you get better to a point and then it plateaus, maybe that's what you're going to get. Then you need to decide, is being 50% better enough for me to have a better quality of life, or is it still unplayable? And then go and have a look at your other options, like for example surgery, which of course does have a place. So that's the answer to the question. There isn't a real answer. It took me 3 months to feel what I judged to be 75% better, and after a year I was running and living a normal life with some discomfort at times, usually, but when I had too much alcohol or had a party and bad food, then I would ache a bit at night. But 90-95% improvement, certainly way better than it was before. So if you have any progress, then you're going in the right direction. Be patient. The next question I get, and this is a video I did specifically explaining the science in as simple way as I could, the science and the biology around a hip joint or any joint structure. Cartilage. What is cartilage? What's it made of? How does it strengthen? Does it repair? Does it not repair? What aspects of it can be fixed up? And when is it impossible to fix? So I'm going to link that in the video notes down here. If you haven't seen it, you should probably give it a watch, because it does help to understand on a basic level how a cartilage how joint cartilage actually works. The question is, how do I know if I still have chondrocytes in my joint? Now, the chondrocytes are the special cells, cartilage cells, it's a type of your body cell, that are embedded in the ends of the bone, and from those cells, collagen is created and pushed up into the joint to create the cartilage matrix that does the shock absorption and helps your joints move and your bones move in the joint. So the functional layer of the cartilage is made of collagen, but it is produced by the chondrocytes. Now, if you wear your cartilage down, you have arthritis now. You have inflammation and your joint is very painful and doesn't work very well. But if you allow the chondrocytes to reproduce collagen, you can rebuild that buffer and you will feel a lot better. But only if your chondrocytes are there. If you grind your joint away so much that you're now wearing away the actual bone and you scrape away a whole layer of bone, you may destroy all your chondrocytes and then they're gone. So the question was, how do you know? Well, you don't know. You need to try the protocol with the food and with the rest and with the exercise to give your body a chance to regrow some of your collagen. And if you do have chondrocytes, they will do it. And if you don't, they won't. Then you'll know. And if you don't, then you need to look at other options. Now, there are possible solutions with stem cell therapy and injections and things. This is not a video about that. Another option is a joint replacement, but you won't actually know whether your chondrocytes are still there or not. But I can tell you that in most cases they are, because to grind the bone down so severely that the chondrocytes themselves are gone, you'd have virtually no movement whatsoever left in that joint and you would be in excruciating pain. So if you're even walking on that joint, I would say chances are very high that you do have chondrocytes still in the ends of the bone and you do have a positive outlook in terms of being able to regenerate at least some level of functional cartilage. So that's the question. The answer to the question is to just try and see how much recovery you can stimulate in your own body. The next question, the third question that I get a lot is around exercise and should I be doing exercise or should I not be doing exercise, and then pain and pain management, and if it hurts, is that good or is it bad? And we need to be very careful with this, because the bottom line rule is if it hurts, don't do it. But a level of discomfort is not always the same as out and out pain. So if you have not been moving your hip much and you're trying to, or your joint, and you're trying to remobilize the hip, that could be your elbow, it could be your knee, you will have very stiff tendons and ligaments around that joint because it hasn't been moving, and it can be very uncomfortable trying to get the range of motion back. Maybe your muscles have shortened a little bit, and that discomfort can be confused with damaged cartilage if you don't really understand what it is you're looking for. So my example was that when I started running again, really, really carefully and really slowly, my hip hurt for about the first 3 minutes, that I was hardly running at all. I was walking, hobbling, limping, and then it eased, and then it was fine. Generally speaking, if your cartilage is damaged and the pain is coming from bone on bone, it's not going to ease into it. It's not going to warm up. It's just going to get worse. Okay, don't do it. When you have muscles and tendons that are a bit stiffened up and a bit achy, and you start using them and you get the blood flowing, then they ease and then you're able to do the exercise. So if that's the case, do the exercise, not necessarily running, just your mobilization exercises. Do them very carefully. Don't over stimulate yourself. Any movement is good. And if it's a little bit achy, control the level of pain and see what happens after a few minutes. If it gets easier, then it's probably a tendon issue. And I have done a video on how a tendon issue can confuse you when you've got when you have a joint problem. So I'm going to link that one down here as well. So the pain is really, you make the call. If the pain is sort of more of an ache rather than a sharp pain and it goes away, then you're okay to do the exercise. If it's a really sharp pain, just stop. Just stop. You don't need to do the exercise. Do the other things first. Eat properly. Get the inflammation down. Allow it to start rebuilding. In time, you will be able to start doing some exercise. And then another question that I get asked a lot is about collagen. And I have done a video on collagen to explain what it is, what collagen actually is, where it comes from, your body makes it, and what it does. So the question though is, if I'm taking a collagen supplement, which type should I take? And there is a popular belief that there are three types. It's certainly in terms of the marketing as a supplement, there appear to be three types. But I can tell you that your body makes 28 types of collagen. And they're pretty much all made from the same amino acids, which are the building blocks of a protein. Collagen is a protein. And your body will mix and match from these amino acids and construct the appropriate collagen for you, whether it's in your skin or in your hair or your fingernails or in your joints or wherever it needs to be. So it probably doesn't really matter what type of supplement you take. And to be honest, you don't necessarily have to take any supplement because your collagen in your body will be built from the amino acids in the proteins that you eat. So if you eat a proper healthy diet with lots of protein, with different sources, so different types of meat, fish, eggs, chicken skin, then your body will have pretty much what it needs, and the supplement should just be an extra little boost, just the cherry on the top, if you like. Supplements by themselves are not going to do it for you if you don't eat properly. So you really need to focus first on your food and make sure that you're getting as much protein as possible from different sources so that you have a different range of amino acids. And then take a collagen supplement because your body will use it if it needs it, and if it doesn't, it won't. So there's no big deal. But I don't think you need to obsess about which collagen it is. See what's available where you live, see what they cost, and see which one you enjoy taking, and then do that. So that's it. Food first, then supplements, then medication. And I'm about to do a video on food, supplements, and medication, because I think we need to get these three concepts into a little bit more of a usable, sensible perspective. So there we go. Four questions answered. I'm going to keep making lists of questions that come, and I will address further more questions in future videos. Thank you very much for your time. Thank you for subscribing. Send in your questions. Who knows, maybe your question will be in my next video. Thank you for your time.